Hi everyone, and welcome back to Fit Reset, your 30-day fitness journey. This is day six. You're almost through with your first week, and we are focusing on shoulders today. Allie's here. She's gonna lead us through our warm-up. So I'm gonna pass the mic over to her, and she's going to kick off this workout for us.
Okay, so coming into the first part of our workout, we're gonna need a light set of weights. I'll be using twos. Are you using twos as well? Okay, and you'll need a heavier set of weights for later on when Kelsie takes over, maybe threes or fours. I don't think we really need anything heavier than that. Is that right, Kelsie? Okay, excellent. So go ahead and grab your light weights. We're just gonna start with a couple warm-up exercises to get the rotator cuffs ready for the heavier weights that we're gonna do. So, first thing we're gonna do is just a regular front raise. Palms are gonna be facing down, lifting up the weights up to shoulder height. You don't wanna come any higher than that. We're just slowly lifting them up and bringing them back down. We're gonna have 30 seconds here, just slow controlled motion, lifting the weights up and bringing them back down. Feet are shoulder width apart. Nice grounded stance. Relax the shoulders away from the head. We got 5 more seconds here. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Next exercise we have here are sword draws. So you can place one of the weights down, and as if we're drawing a sword from the waist, keeping a slight bend in the elbows, palms facing down, coming up, and lifting the palm faces away from the body, putting the sword back into the sheath. Coming up, palm faces away, coming back in, palm faces towards the body again. Again, we're doing 30 seconds here. Nice, slow, controlled motion. Shoulders are relaxed. And all the way up, make sure you're doing full motions. Not selling yourself short. 5 more seconds here before we switch hands. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and transfer the weight to the opposite hand. Same motion, just using the other side. Palm is facing in towards the body, then opens up, facing away from you. This is a diagonal motion. So we're not coming too far out to the side here, and we're not coming straight up. It should be like a perfect diagonal away from the body. And 3, 2, and 1. Nice. Go ahead and pick up your other weight. The next exercise we're going to be doing is goalpost rotation. So starting with your arms in a goalpost position, you're just bending them straight down and coming straight back up. So there's no motion in the shoulders, it's just a rotation. Excuse me, the elbows. Just rotating down and coming back up. Palms facing forwards, palms facing down. Make sure you have a nice solid grip on your weight. You want to make sure all your fingers are wrapped around. Keep the shoulders relaxed. Don't let the elbows come up higher than the shoulders. 5 more seconds here. 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and relax. Shake the shoulders out a bit. Next, we have forward circles. So, bringing the arms out to a T. Just small rotations forward, drawing small circles forward. Again, it's a nice controlled motion. If this feels like too much stress, you can tilt the palms downwards a bit. That'll take some of the stress off the rotator cuff. Ten more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Switching to a backwards rotation now. Again, same concept, nice, slow, controlled motion. If the weights become too much, you can always place them down and just use your arms, the weight of your arms. 10 more seconds here. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and shake those arms out a bit. That last one was a doozy. Even though you're using twos, it still becomes heavy after a while. The last thing we're gonna do is what I like to call no monies. So, palms are facing up, elbows are pinched towards the body. It's important that you don't let the elbows come away. And all you're doing is opening up the hand saying, I got no money. So, the hands come together in front, opening up, pinching the shoulder blades back. Opening, pinching back, coming back together. Not letting the elbows, the biceps come away from the body. Just opening and coming back together. 10 more seconds here. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Go ahead and set those light weights down and get your heavy weights ready because Kelsie's coming in with the intense part here. So I hope you're feeling warmed up.
Alrighty, everyone. So I've got my threes and we're gonna get to work with our first ladder. So the way ladders work, if you do not know what a ladder is, we climb up the ladder. And then we go down the ladder. Makes sense, right? Sounds easy, but in practice, not so much. So our first ladder, we're gonna be working the front of the shoulders. Our second ladder will be working the back of the shoulders. So what that ladder is going to look like is we're doing a dumbbell six way. So I'm gonna show you just the movements of the dumbbell six way first and then explain the concept behind the ladder. So your six movements are a lateral raise, to the center, and then all the way up overhead, nice and controlled. Then back down to the center, pause, open back out, drop down. So now that's round one. We continuously build upon it, right? So then we'll do two lateral raises, and then two to the center, et cetera, et cetera. I promise you it'll make sense as we go along, so let's just get it started. We're gonna start with one way each way. So here we go. Take a slight bend in the knees, press the pelvis forward, relax the shoulders down. Let's get into our dumbbell six ways. So one way first, we go up to the center, nice and controlled, raise the weights all the way up overhead. Nice and controlled, bring it back down. Open the arms all the way out, send it back down. Now we do two of each. So it's two lateral raises. So we go one, two, and then two to the center. So that's one, two, now two up. One, two. Once again, two times we open up. One, two, and two times down. Up, down, up. Now ready three times of those lateral raises. One, two, three, try not to race through it. Three times to the center. Stay nice and slow and controlled. I'm so glad I grabbed threes and not fives. Three times, up, stop, up, down. I know the tendency is to drop the palms all the way down. Don't do it. Three times you open, out, in, out, in, out. Now three times lateral raises. It's really gonna feel like seven because we're going straight into those four next. So here we go. One, two, we're only going up to five. We'll take a little break before we climb down the ladder. Thank God, right? Here we go, four times to the center. One, two, three, four. Four times up and down, I'm shaking.
Woo! No shame.
Here we go. One, two, three, four. Four lateral raises right into five lateral raises. Oh my goodness. Why did I choose to do this exercise? All right, here we go. Last time through, 5 lateral raises. You got it. Make sure you keep your posture nice, nice, nice. There's no leaning the hips forwards to get the weights up. You're still controlled. If you can't be controlled, you can always go weightless. One more before we go center. Here we go. 5 times center. Five times up. I don't want to see this. Don't let the weights move you. You move the weights. Core is nice and tight. One more. Woo! 5 times, open it up. Oh my goodness. Woo! 5 times lateral raise, you got it. I feel like I have to pep talk myself to get through this. And whew, take a break before we climb down the ladder. Wow, I humbled myself. I'm switching to 2s for that next one. Imagine me thinking that I could do that with 5. So now we are climbing down the ladder. So we start with 5 until we get all the way down to 1. Let's do it. 5 lateral raises to start. 1, 2, and muscles are still kind of fiery. 3, 4, and 5. 5 in. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 lateral raises, but it's gonna feel like 9. Not feel like 9, it technically is 9. Good, now let's start with 4. I always like climbing down the ladder way better, because it gets easier and easier instead of harder and harder. 4 to the center. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 up. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 out. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 lateral raises. Whew. I got my sweat on. Wow, I was sweating during the warm up. Didn't take long. All right, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. My delts are quivering. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, now to 2, we're almost there, thank God. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Last time, oh my goodness, fight for it. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. 1. Whew. That got ugly at the end, but we got through it. Oh my gosh. Whew. Yeah, I'm gonna just do some windmills here. We're both just kind of doing what our body wants right now after that. Yeah, that medial delt too, really feel it. All right, so I'm gonna go back to my 3s. Let's see how long I can keep them for this next ladder. So I'm gonna show you the ladder first. Like I said, we're working the back of the shoulders now. So, pretty basic. We're gonna come into a hinged position. So slight bends in the knees, reaching your chest slightly forwards. And your palms are gonna be faced in towards your body. And we're gonna go up to 5 with this. It's just 2 movements, so a lot better than that first 6 motion one. All you're gonna do is take a hip hinge high row. So you're gonna bring the palms of the arms up so you feel a squeeze in the shoulder blades. bring it down, flip the palms in, take it into a rear delt fly, open it up nice and slow and controlled, slowly bring it down, and then we'll move on and go up from there, starting with one of each movement, going all the way to five, taking a break, and then going from five down. Let's do it. All right, so Allie's giving you that front view and you'll get the side view from me. All right, so palms face in, let's do it. Up, down, in, open. Now going to two. One, two, one, two. Now to three. One, two, three, one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Last one. One, two, three, four, five, and one, two, three, four, five. Nice. Take a little bit of a breather before we climb down the ladder. Let's take 30 seconds. Yeah. Take those weights all the way down. Do what you gotta do. We climb down the ladder, and then all we have is a 2-minute little bonus round that we're gonna finish out this workout with. So you guys are almost there. Whew. Pick up those weights, love to go again. But do I really wanna go again? We'll go again. Okay. Bend in the knees, chest forward, gazing straight down. Always remember you want your neck to be in line with the rest of the spine. Here we go, starting with five. One, two, three, four, five, and one, two, three, four, five, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. Now to three, almost there. We love climbing down the ladder. One, two, three. Now to two. One, two, one, two. Last one. One, one, done. All right. So we got through ladders. Now all we have is a 2-minute AMRAP. AMRAP stands for as many rounds as possible. And this is gonna be body weight with no weights whatsoever, just using your body. That's gonna be enough for you. It should also get your heart rate up. So it's gonna be a little cardio at the end there. So I'm gonna show you what it is. Then we're gonna put 2 minutes on the clock and we'll see. We'll have a little friendly competition. See who can get the most rounds. Then you guys can leave a comment down below. Let us know how many rounds you got to. So here it is. 2 minutes, you're gonna be in a plank position. We're gonna go into a commando. So dropping down, pressing back up, then turning over into a side plank one side, turning over to a side plank the other side, back into that plank, dropping down forearm plank, pressing up forearm plank. Modification, drop your knees down and you can take that commando on the knees and then just roll over this way if your weights aren't in the way like mine are. Okay, ready position. 2 minutes on the clock. We begin in five, four, three, two, and go. So even though we're having a friendly competition here, you don't want to be in a rush with these, right? The most effective way to do your strength training is to really go slow. challenges the muscles even more. We're also getting some nice core action here, so that's always good. We're 30 seconds in. Again, as we go on, you might need to start to modify a little bit. Feel free, always can take that modification. You can even take a brief child's pose and come back into it if it becomes too intense. There's so many ways to get through it, so get through it. We're almost halfway through. Headed right into a child's pose after this. Whew. Oh yeah, second minute's definitely harder.
I hate to tell you, but I already lost count.
Oh yeah, I haven't been counting.
We'll have to watch the video after.
Yeah, we'll have to, yeah, exactly. That's how we'll count. We'll just watch the footage later. Ooh. Oh, I'm feeling it all, shoulders and core.
You know me, I was feeling it play for the monster pose.
That's right. Less than 30 seconds to go, guys. The reps are getting uglier by the second. Final 15, stick it out. Five, four, three, two, and one. We were both like, nah.
We were like, I look over there,
I'm
like, is she gonna do the bonus rep?
We're not getting that last one in. Take a child's pose, you guys. Whew.
The best part.
Drop your head down. Just let your breath flow back to its natural rhythm.
We're just gonna come into a puppy stretch to stretch out the shoulders a little bit. So, coming up onto your knees, keeping your tush up, you're gonna walk your hands all the way out nice and far in front of you, and then try to drop the elbows down. Now you wanna make sure your arms are like two railroad tracks, and then if you can, dropping the forehead down, maybe even getting the chest down. And then from here, we're just gonna slither our way forwards into a Sphinx. You like that?
Yeah.
I thought you'd like that one. If it feels good, you can press into the palms, lift all the way up into a seal. Good. Take the hands back in towards your body. Take it all the way to sit down onto your tushies. Good. Just one more stretch before I sign off for the day. Raise your right arm all the way up and take your right hand behind your shoulder blades and then grab hold of your right elbow with your left hand and just gently take a side body stretch, reaching over to the left side, maybe lifting your gaze up to the right corner of the room. Inhale, both arms come all the way up. Shake it out for a second. Other side, left arm comes all the way up. Take it in between the shoulder blades. Grab hold of the left elbow with the right hand and then gently guide it into a side body stretch towards the right side, gazing to the left corner of the room. And slowly release. Awesome, awesome work today, guys. Thank you so, so much for joining me today. And I hope to see you guys day 7, day 8, day 9, and beyond.